Welcome to Reach Goals. Today, I have a very interesting topic to discuss, that is distributed transactions. And the questions goes like this. What's the distributed transaction and how the distributed transactions works in the microservices? So let's see what is distributed transaction. Let's say you have a client and the client in turn connects to the services and the services in turn connects to the database, right? So here the database is co-located and you can do all the transactions. You can lock the table, you can create, update, delete the records because it is located at the same location, right? So now, if you have a database which is located at different locations, let's see how it can be done, right? So let's take a case like you have a client which is connected to the order services and order services are connecting to a database. Now, you see a payment services and it turn connects to a different database and this payment service and the database can be located at different location or it can be out of a different network. In this case, there is no way we can do a transaction between two different databases or two different tables which are located at two different databases, right? So here we cannot apply any of the ACID transactions. So let's see how we are going to achieve this. So in this case, we have a very interesting design pattern which is called SAGAs, where we can use that pattern to apply the distributed transaction across the tables which are located at different locations, right? So let's see how the distributed transactions using SAGA's design pattern works in the microservice based architecture, right? Let's say you have a client. The client in turn connects to the services, which is an order service. An order service in turn connects to the database where you maintain all your orders. Now I want to place an order. And the order goes into the order service and it gets created in the database, right? So now we are going to maintain a state in the table where I call it as the created, right? So now can we fulfill this order? No, because we have not received the payment. As we saw in the previous screen, the payment is in a different database and the service is also located at the different location. So how do I make sure that payment is available for this order? So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to send a message from order service to the payment service. The payment service in turn checks for the user's credit card information and makes sure the payment is available or not. Let's say if the payment is not available, right, and what it goes is it sends again back to the order services with a message which we call it as the rejected. So the created gets changed into the rejected. So the order is completely cancelled, which is similar to what we call as the rollback, right? So let's take in the happy path, right? So let's say user does the same order, like, you know, he places an order and it goes to the order service and the order gets created, right? Now, in the other case, we notice that there is a funds available for the customer, right? So if the funds are available, what it has is, again, the reverse message is sent back to the order service saying that it is approved, right? So what happens over here is the created state becomes approved and in this case, you can fulfill the order, right? So that is how the whole transaction works and this is how where we can achieve the distributed transaction using the SAGA's design pattern, right? Thanks for watching. Bye.